sorry.
All the time.
What's up, everybody? I'm excited. From here to there. I mean, I've been sick lately. I lost 80 pounds. And no one didn't break those little teeth out. But no, really, it was tough for me, man. I was sick and I couldn't play with my grandkids or my kids. I'd be playing with my son, calling timeout for everything. I'd be like, oh, fuck. Timeout, son, timeout. He said, Dad, we're just playing checkers. I said, I know. Man, I'm sick, I'm sick, fuck. I mean, I'm like, okay, Dad, just gotta get better. And I did. I went on the internet and hooked up some healing things for me. I got some medicine, it got better, and took care of myself, and things got better for me. And so I've been doing that. I've been getting on the internet, and Adam called me one night. I was on the internet searching, because I like to search things on the internet. Cures and different things like, is there really a Bigfoot? You know? Did that old lady give me the oval? You know? Because she was dogging me for a little bit, so I had my mom break the egg and shit. But we're Christian, so we don't do that. So it was in black. And so Adam gives me a call, and I'm on the internet just looking around, and he says, hey, Paulie. He gives me a call and says, hey, Paulie, I need you to roast me. And I was like, fuck, man, as much as you drink, you're going to burn for like 3 days. You know? I don't like 3 days. So, you know, no, you're going to say stuff good to me and say different, you know, say things good about me. I said, oh, okay. So I got some notes here. I want to see. Right?
Real hurt, real hurt.
Yeah. Here we go. Here we go, bread, milk, eggs, torpedoes, tampons. Oh, hold on. That's my honeydew list. Hold on. I'm fucking lost, man. So, I'm gonna wing it. I'm just gonna kind of wing it off of memory with me and Adam. We go back to high school, junior high. He was a bad little breaker. See, back then we used to wear Bogarts and Adidas sweats, but Adam was the first dude to wear tight pants. You know? And, I mean, they were so tight, my niachi would be like, whoa! So, you know, that's what I loved about him. He was the innovator. And also, I know the real reason why they call him Shorty. I'm gonna let you know right now, okay? If you all didn't know, Adam shut his dick off. And he was wearing those tight pants, and he had a gun in his waist. And he tried to pull it out to show everybody. He tugged, he tugged. After the third tug, fucking shot his dick. So we all at the emergency room, we're all there just praying, hope he's okay. And the doctor comes out, and he's like, I got some good news. We're not going to charge him for the sewing. I only took a stitch. Okay, so we're not going to charge him. All right, good. He said, but there's a problem, though. He's a little sorry. That's where his nickname came from. So, that's the real reason. So, he happened to cut off all the foreskin. That fool had like a foreskin of like 5 inches. And when we would take showers after gym class, he'd come play with it like a slinky. You know, gross everybody out. And he finally got it cut off. So when you see that big old piece of chicharrón on his wall, that's his foreskin. It's not a snake. He said he caught a snake and he shed the skin. That's his first thing, so that's it about Adam, you know, yeah. And also, too, he said he did stand-up for about a year ago. He lied. Me and him had to act together. I was a ventriloquist, and he was sitting on my lap. He would toast up the storm. He would say all kinds of shit. I would damn near get my ass kicked, because he's flirting with all the ladies. It was just me. You know, and so the hardest part about Adam was I put him in his box and that motherfucker keep getting out. You know? So in the morning when I got up, It'd be a big ass mess in his box. Bulls farm, fucking weed, nut everywhere, and I had to clean it up. And I was like, man, that's like a plus. And Adam used to always dress up like different characters. Chiquita Banana, you know, from Raggedy Ann. He used to do shit like that just to lighten up the show. And one show, he comes up to me, he gets this fine ass girl who's dancing. I gotta get at her. And I look, and fucking her husband's a biker. And I'm like, dude, you can get me fucked up, you know? He's like, no, we'll make it look real. I want it to look real. And he did, he showed up, fucking dressed like Prince. You know? He even had the ass cut out the pockets. You know? And I was like, man, you're taking it too far, bro. And he's like, no, you know what? We gotta take it further. You need to put your hand up my ass so she looks real. So 2 hours later, we're negotiating. I took some of the money, some of the pay. I said, okay. That was the worst day of my life, man. I stuck my hand up there, and we're doing the show. He's rapping to her. He's like, hey, what's up, baby? Dogging on, dude. And I'm sitting there going, oh, shit. And the biker dude's looking at me. Like, I'm saying it. I ain't saying shit, you know? So I get a glass of water. I'm drinking it. Talking. Da-da-da-da. And I'm like, dude. And then the smell through my hands and his ass. And I was like, you know? And then he's like, this is great. I'm gonna get at this girl. And I was like, fuck you are. And I got him and I went to the back. I threw his ass in the box, you know, popped him out real quick, and threw him in the box. And then after that, I loaded him up and I ran out the door. As I walked out the door, something hit me. I don't know what it was. And so from that point, I woke up in the hospital. Doctor said, you got a black eye, concussion. I said, well, how did I get here? I don't know. They found you at the steps. Fucking Adam, man. So I said, okay. So I get up, I walk out, I said, I see Adam. He's sitting there, smiling, like smiling. This is and I said, Adam, man, I'm going to add on to our show. I want you to stand about 10 feet, turn around, bend over. Yeah, give me the girls this way. Watch this, listen. So then I walked back and I kicked that motherfucker about 20 yards. I said, you're fired, bitch. Okay. So that was it on our little melee we had there on our little show about us doing that. But also, too, after I let him go, I went to a depression. I didn't have nothing to do. The ventriloquist act didn't work no more. I can't do that. And so I ended up doing life of crime, and I went to prison. For a whole year, I was in prison, and it was sad. But I got a hang of it. Hey, whatever. Gang rape, whatever. So, just about a year goes by, and I get a new cell. And I'm sitting there reading my self-improvement book, eating a banana. And the door opens, I hear this commotion. And I hear, hey, baby, what's up? What's up, snack size? And I'm going to get in that ass. I was like, oh, shit, this guy must be hot. I don't know. So the door opens up, and it's Adam. He's my new Shelly. I was like, hell yeah, it's my boy. And he was crying because he was scared. I was like, what's wrong, y'all? Man, what a fucking rookie. He's like, my ass turned around my booty. And I was like, dude, you're with me. You're safe.
We're good.
Thank you. I sat him down. I told him, look, this is how it goes, this is how it is, this is how prison works. And I said, okay, last point. Me and you, we have a union here. Okay, like a man and a woman, like a husband and a wife. So I'm gonna let you choose, Adam. I'm gonna let you choose. You can be a husband or you can be the wife. So what do you think Adam chose? I'm gonna be your husband, huh? I said, Adam, that's good. Now come over here and suck your wife's dick. Well, yeah, that's it for me right now. I love Adam. Yeah. Give him a boy. Respect you a lot. You know, you being on stage and doing this, it used to be tough. You know, never give up, man, because someday someone will laugh at your jokes.
Oh, yeah, for sure.